What's up, guys? I'm Hargon. Welcome back to the egg hatching episode of this Pokemon Sacred Gold Egglocke challenge. And so you already know this series is done. We have actually defeated this series. And if you look at our team, this is what is left of our team after we have defeated the whole entire game. 16 gym badges, defeated the Elite Four twice, and defeated a red on top of Mount Silver. And so now we're gonna just be hatching eggs for this whole episode, so it might be a long time because there's actually still quite a bit of eggs to hatch. Because let me go in here and let's go see our eggs. So I rearranged the eggs, so now there are, it's just nothing but, it's actually 4 full boxes of eggs plus a little more in box 5. That's how much we still have left over, which is freaking awesome. I still want to thank all you guys for the awesome support on this series and sending in all these eggs. That is just amazing. Just too amazing, man. I wouldn't think I would get this many eggs, to be honest. And this is my dead box, almost a full box of eggs, or of eggs, almost a full box of deaths right there. It's crazy. I already did my death montage, as you guys already saw. My y'all guys told me that to in the future do my egg hatching episode before the death montage, so I will do that. But at first I was thinking that I would give people enough time to answer or to put questions in the final episode. I would give them enough time to put questions so I can answer them in the egg hatching. So I put the death montage before the egg hatching just to see if anybody would put in any more questions. But yeah, now I know. And we still had over 2 boxes of backups of Pokemon that we were able to still use. Crazy stuff. A lot of them were, I bet if I split them between Ubers, like legendaries and regular Pokemon, there would be like, it would be half and half. Like, I swear there's, we has a bunch of legendaries. And then, yeah, so let's go over here. This is all the, there's a little more than 3 boxes full of swaps. So we hatched, this is how many egg swaps we had. 3 full boxes and a little more in box 4. That is crazy stuff, and we still have even more eggs to hatch. So we're gonna go in and start hatching these eggs. I guess I could deposit, how do we make this efficient? I guess let's deposit the rest of our Pokemon that we have, except for one, because we need at least one Pokemon in our team right now. So let's keep Jack in our team, I guess. All right, so we're gonna have one Pokemon in our box, and then we'll just put all these eggs in our team right here. Ooh, how would that work though? Do they all hatch at the same time? Because it only takes like one step. I don't even know, to be honest with you guys. So yeah, I'm not really going to let's see. The items don't matter and the nicknames don't matter anymore, so I'm just gonna hatch them and just like not even nickname them. And I don't even have to check the I don't have to check their movesets or anything like that. So all right, so we're actually, I'm gonna look at the names though. So we got Kermit, Bleezus, Sia, there's no name, and then Yeti. Yeti. All right, so let's go ahead and hatch one. I think it goes in order. I think Kermit should be hatching first. So I think Kermit the Frog, what is it, a Politoed again? Yeah, it would have been a Politoed. All right, cool. So yeah, these are all the eggs. Thank you guys once again for sending in all the eggs and all that good stuff. So, okay, so we just keep on taking one step for all the eggs to hatch. And this is Bleezus. I don't know. I never actually watched any egg hatching. Oh, a shiny Azure looks nice. That green, I like it. But yeah, shoot, what was I gonna say? Oh yeah, I never watched any egg hatching episodes before on YouTube, so I don't know how the format of this egg hatching works, but I think this is similar. We just go ahead and hatch all of them. And just to show you guys, this is Sia. Yeah, I guess I'll just show you guys a nickname so you know which ones, so you guys know which ones I'm hatching. It hatches in order, so it was like, what was it? Kermit, then Bleezus, then Sia, and this is the no-name egg. And then the next one should be the, what is it? That I can't even remember that name. What was the name of it? Yeti. Alright, so yeah. So you guys should know, even though I don't have to nickname them still. But yeah, so now we're gonna be hatching all these. This actually might not even take that long. Ooh, another Snover. Alright. Yeah, it still blows my mind that this whatchamacallit, this series has been going on for about 6 months, actually, since June, and it is just crazy that it's actually ending, and I'm already like almost done with my first semester in this college over here. So that's insane, man. That's insane. This series has been like a transformation for me and my channel. That's what it feels like. And a lot of you guys let me know that, yeah, so this episode is pretty much gonna be real talking, just saying stuff that's on my mind, hatching eggs, and then I'm gonna actually answer your questions in a little bit. So, or actually, I can do that right now. I'm gonna go ahead and answer some questions that you have right now. I'll put them on the screen in the little question of the day box if it fits. But anyway, we got Uno, Bat, Bug, Land Hippo, and Yen. Alright, so, of course it goes in order, so I should know which one is your egg if you sent it. Uno is Articuno, I would have guessed that. Alright, we'll see. I'm gonna go ahead and answer some questions you guys have. I think I'm gonna be switching off between two people, because I think only like two people, actually asked the questions. So, let's go here. Who's this guy? Okay, Five Taken, or however, I can't pronounce any names. So here's the first question that he has for me. Has this lock changed your thoughts on some Pokemon or brought them into your top list? If not top list, at least as one of your favorite Pokemon of that type. I have a hard time reading, like, god dang. Okay, so has this lock changed your thoughts on some Pokemon and brought them into your top list? Not really. It hasn't. Well, it definitely changed my thoughts on some Pokemon, for sure. But it hasn't brought them into my top list, because I always have my team of, I always have my powerhouse list that I just like. I have Pokemon that I just love using. But other than that, it definitely changed my thoughts on some Pokemon. Like, of course, freaking Lopunny, that Atractor. Yeah, Atractor the Lopunny. This lock has definitely changed my thoughts on that, because he got the elemental punches and he put in the work against Lance the champion. Like, I was not expecting that at all, which is probably like the magic about this series, which is why I love this series so much. Let's see, Hippopotas. All these are shinies, that's pretty cool. But yeah, I don't think, it definitely changed my thoughts on some Pokemon. Of course, Kangaskhan too, he put in some work. Like, all the unique Pokemon that I used throughout the series definitely made me like appreciate them, and made me realize how that a lot of Pokemon can have a lot of power behind them. But I don't think I prefer any more Pokemon than the ones I already preferred earlier or before doing the series. And so yeah, that, I think that answered that question. Yeah, so I haven't gotten any Pokemon in my top list yet. Or yeah, any new Pokemon in my top list of Pokemon that I like using. Still the same to me, but I appreciate the weaker, the quote weaker Pokemon now, since they can have some good power behind them. Alright, so let me get the next batch of eggs in my list, or in my box. And this egg, man, I'll tell you what, this egg right here, I've been hoping, crossing my fingers, that I would actually hatch this egg, because I actually wanted to find out what the heck this egg is. And people actually told me, like, in the first episode, that this egg is actually pretty dang special. That's why it looks like that. So I really want to kind of sucks that I wasn't able to hatch it on cam, but during the series. But now we're gonna hatch it and we'll finally find out what it is. So we got No Feet, Aroused, Diddy, 20versary, and Caesar. I could guess that Caesar is Infernape or Champ. Or not Champ, Chimchar. Dang it, I got my nicknames all messed up now. Forever, Champ is forever in my heart now. Okay, so we left off on that one question about the lock. So let's go to the next question from Zach Whalen. Or how are you pronounce that again? So do you like being do you like being on top or bottom? I did say you can ask any question. Obviously top, man. Obviously top. Cause it shows dominance. Nah, just kidding. Alright, we're not gonna go into depth on that question. Alright, next question from Five Taken. What is your favorite evolution method in Pokemon? favorite evolution method. So I'm guessing that's like evolving by happiness, by level up, by stones. Hey, Baneri. Cute little Baneri. I would have to say favorite method for evolution is probably by a stone, because I'm pretty lazy, and stones are like the easiest thing to evolve a Pokemon with, so yeah, I guess I'll just have to say evolutionary stone, unless Megas count. Nah, either way, I think stones are the best option for evolving a Pokemon. Quick and easy, and don't have to do too much with it. Alright, so let's get to the next question right here. From, oh, here it is. Dude, this thing hatches differently. Oh, Manaphy egg. Okay, that was a shiny Manaphy too. Dang. You know, if that was my starter, that would, you know how sick this series would have been if that Manaphy was my starter. So 20-versary was a Manaphy. Dang. That was the only Manaphy then, because there's no other eggs like that. And of course, Caesar was Chimchar, which like I predicted. But dang, that is nice. That is nice. Okay. So next question from Zach Whalen. So do you like... Oh wait, I was about to read the same question. If you could be any champ from Pokemon, who would you be and why? Whew, this is actually a tough one. The obvious choice would be Steven, because Steven is actually my favorite. He's actually my favorite champion. But it would have to be between either Steven or Lance, though. Because they're both really cool. Really cool champions, in my opinion. But if I had to choose just one, though, I would have to go with... I'd have to go with Steven. Just because he's just a cool guy like that. And he has Steel-type Pokemon, and, you know, I actually really like Steel-type Pokemon. Even though they got really... Even though they, like, their tier was lowered in 6th gen because they lost their a lot of resistance. Even though they're strong against Fairy, I think, but they lost their resistance against some other types, so... But I really like Steel types. Of course, like, using Bronzong, that's, like, probably one of my favorite Pokemons. Because, yeah, most of my favorite Pokemons were Pokemon that were good in battles back when I used to battle competitively in 5th gen. But... Yeah, definitely Steven for its cool typing. I feel like he represents me the most. Alright, so... Oh, I forgot to give you all the nicknames for these. Oh, I forgot to read off the nicknames for you guys. Shoot. I'll have to remember that to do that next time. Okay, so let's switch off to the next... the next question. Five Taken asks... What is your favorite movie? Oh, shoot. Favorite movie. You know, these are like... These kind of questions, these are like the basic questions that like you have to answer in school to get like, you know, on the first day of school, whenever you give like a basic set of questions that you have to answer to the class just to, like, so everybody can know you better. I always hate those kind of questions. But favorite movie, I was never good with just like narrowing down like one, my favorite song or favorite movie like that. Favorite movie though, shoot man, honestly, favorite movie. I actually never thought about this yet, because this is my first time like actually like thinking about the question. Favorite movie. I don't want to say something dumb. Like, I don't know if it. I honestly don't know my favorite movie. Like Harry Potter series. Those are all good movies. I like those a lot. I honestly blank out when I think about movies, though. I just have to go with Harry Potter. One of the Harry Potter movies. I always love those movies. But yeah, I guess that's a solid answer, Harry Potter. I forgot to show the nicknames again. Okay, I'll have to do that after this. Okay, let's see, another one. Okay, oh, that's a... Didn't we just hatch a Golpin? Okay. Okay. Another question is, a Pokemon based on a Gargoyle would be cool. It would have high defense during the day and high attack during the night. It will be pure rock in the daytime and a dark slash rock type at night. What do you think about that? A gargoyle Pokemon. So I don't think we ever actually had a gargoyle Pokemon before. Unless, like, do we? I don't think there is a gargoyle Pokemon. Unless it's like Hydreigon, maybe. I don't know. Oh, I forgot to show you the nicknames. So we had a Gulpin and a Phanpy. The next one is Troll. There's no name here, and then there's Pockets. Okay. So this one is Troll. But yeah. But I think that a Pokemon like that would be pretty cool. It changes forms, or changes typings, from day and night. And it has high attack and high defense. So I guess it would be like a really bulky physical threat, but it wouldn't be too fast. I think that would be a pretty cool idea for a Pokemon, though. I like that. Hey, Magnemite. Oh, that would have been cool, man. Okay. So, yeah, I think that answers the question. I think that a Gargoyle Pokemon with that kind of stats and typing would be actually really dang cool. 8th gen. Bring it into 8th gen. Alright, so let's finish the remaining questions while we're hatching this no-name egg right here. Netflix chill or Netflix and chill? Ooh, that's a lot of options right there. Netflix chill or Netflix and chill? Probably Netflix and chill, because you have best of both worlds, right? Because if you're just chilling and you get bored and want to do something, you got Netflix right there just to keep you occupied, keep your mind occupied, right? I'm giving too much thought with this question right here. Netflix and chill. God dang it. Okay, let's put these guys back. Okay. And I think there's only like two more questions. No, there's like four more questions left from five taken. So we're gonna answer the rest of these questions while we're hatching. We only barely finished one box, and we're already 20 minutes into this video. What? This is gonna be over an hour video. Another video over an hour. Okay, so we got Cleo, Spyro, Anubis, Fat Bat, and Dominator. Okay, so Cleo first. Okay. But god dang. This is gonna be an hour episode, guys. Which you probably won't already know by the time you click on this video. Cleo is the Golding. That would have been another unique Pokemon. Okay, so the next question is, if you were a genie and a person said, I wish you would not grant me this wish, what would you do? You know what I would do? I look at that person and say, wish granted, and then walk away. Because his wish was granted, right? I didn't grant the wish, so I granted his wish and said, see ya. That's a brain buster right there. But that's my answer. Okay. My boy Bagon. I was going to say Bacon. We never got to use Bacon. I'm pretty sure you had Bacon, right? Okay, anyway. Oh, my phone. Good thing I got a case. Okay, so next question is, did you go to your high school prom? And if so, how was it, and did you have a date? Okay, so I actually didn't go to my high school prom. I actually have a funny story about this, actually. So high school prom I didn't really go to, mainly because I think prom is mainly for just hanging out with your friends most of the time, and I usually talk to like people who were under my grades. I didn't have too many friends that were like seniors with me who were in my grade, so basically most people I knew or talked to mostly weren't able to go to prom. And the people who were in my grade, none of them actually went to prom either, just because, I don't know, I guess we're not about that party life. Yeah, most of my friends aren't really big party people in high school. What about, there was a story, oh yeah, that was actually a funny story though. Okay, let me get my next batch of eggs first before I tell this story. It was actually about, I could have went to prom though and had a date to prom, but I was just an idiot. So pretty much there's this chick that I I guess I didn't really talk to her too much throughout the years in high school, but like we knew each other and like said hi every now and then to each other. So this was like a week or two before the prom, I think. And I haven't talked to her like throughout. I didn't really talk to her like for the whole year. But then a week or two before the prom starts, or before the prom, she just randomly comes up to me during lunch and just like sits with me and just like starts talking with me. I'm like, oh hey, what's up? How you doing? And then she brings up prom, right? She asked me if I'm going to prom. I'm like, nah, I'm not. I don't really care too. Oh, I forgot to show you all the names. But yeah, I was like, nah, I don't really care too much to go to prom. So I asked her, are you going to prom? And she's like, I don't know yet, cause I don't have a date. I was like, oh, damn, that. I said, oh, damn, that sucks. And she was like, yeah. So then, yeah, we kept on talking, finished our conversation. She left. Because we had to go to our next class after lunch ended. Okay, so we got Doyle, Drago, and QB. I forgot to show the names, I'm sorry. But yeah, and then it wasn't until later that I realized, wait, did she want... She told me, she randomly comes up to me and talks about prom and says she doesn't have a date. Was she hinting me to ask her to the prom? And after that, I was like, oh my gosh, I'm an idiot. I told my friends about this, and they said, dude, she wanted to go to prom with you. Why didn't you ask her? I was like, why didn't I? I'm an idiot. So, I could have had a date to prom. I could have went to prom. But I'm an idiot, and I can't take any hints, apparently. I'm not used to taking hints from people, from girls especially. So I didn't go to prom. I don't even remember what I did during the day of prom. I probably recorded another YouTube video or something. But I don't feel like I missed out on prom. You see a bunch of pictures on Facebook, of course, about people going to prom, but the day after prom, everybody was at school, and nobody really talked about it too much. Like, it seemed like another day, like, it seemed like nothing even happened at prom. Like, I don't think I missed out too much. Like, if you're gonna go to prom, I think, if I would've went to prom, I wouldn't have had many people to talk to, because none of the people that I was close to went to prom, so. Like, I think I would've been just dumb to go just to say you went to prom, because I feel like it would've been a waste of time, because I didn't have anybody, I wouldn't have enjoyed myself, if that makes sense. Nobody ever talked about it after that day. Like, you just saw pictures on Facebook for one day, boom. It's like, it never happened. It seems like it wasn't too big of a deal. But if you want to go, do it. Just do it. Okay, I forgot to show you all the names again. So we got an Illumise right here. Next one is Ice. We got Fat Egg. We got Hokage. I think that's an Entei from Manaphy's Snakewood. Yeah, I think that was a Snakewood series. Hokage, I'm guessing that's going to be Entei. And then we got a no-name egg again. Alright, so let's keep on hatching. Now let's get to the last question. Oh no, they have two more questions. Alright, so second to last question is, do you have any guilty pleasures? Guilty pleasures. I never knew what that actually meant. Reg Ice Ice, okay. Spitting ice, vanilla ice. Okay, guilty pleasures. Whataburger. I think that counts as one, right? Definitely, yeah, definitely Whataburger. If you don't know what Whataburger is, it's obviously a burger joint, right? One of the, probably my favorite, no, it's definitely my favorite place to eat burgers at. Such a good place to eat. The patty melt is my favorite, it's my favorite item to get at Whataburger. That's my guilty pleasure. I eat it more than I should. Like, it's not even funny. Another guilty pleasures. Oh, Hokage the Entei. There we go. I guessed it right. I think that's it. I can't think of anything else that I'm guilty about liking. No, I think that's it. Freaking Whataburger, man, consumes me. Alright, the last question is, how many countries have you been to? Oh, that's actually a good question. Including the US, because I live in the US. Including the US, I've been to two countries. the US, and then I don't want to say United Kingdom. That's not a country, is it? No, it's England. England's the country specifically, right? Yeah, England. yeah, so I live in the US, and I've been to England, which I actually just recently went there. It was, whatchamacallit? What was it? It was in 2015. Yeah, 2015. It was New Year's on 2015. So I was there in 2014, and then New Year's passed, and then I was there in 2015 as well. Because I actually, if you don't know, I was in marching band throughout my high school years. And our high school band got invited to perform at the London New Year's Day Parade. So, yeah, we went over there during my senior year. And we marched in the parade in London. Marched in the New Year's Day Parade in London. And, so yeah, that's the only reason why I was able to go outside the country. Alright, so we got Zaraia. We got King Pico. That's probably a Pelipper or a Wingull. We got These Hands, which is probably a Choke. Machamp. We got Cab, and then Clinton. Clinton. Okay. But yeah, what was I saying? Yeah, we went there. So yeah, that was the only reason why I was able to go to England. I had fun there. Got to actually meet up with one of my friends that I actually knew from the internet. Which is actually my first meetup with somebody over the internet. Which is crazy, because you would think that I would meet up with somebody who lives in the US who I know. But I actually ended up being someone outside of the country. But yeah, it was a fun time overall. Yeah, so two countries. I'm not really too big of a traveling person. Dang, shiny Slackoff looks sick. And then I think outside in the US, I think I've only been to like four different states, something like that. I don't travel too much, cause freaking I live in Texas, right? And Texas is just too dang big. So going to another city in Texas feels like going to another state in like the north or something. I don't even know. Yeah, but yeah, that's my life. I'm not too big of traveling. Like even me just moving 4 hours away from my house to go to college, it's just like, feels like so far away, right? Because it's a pretty big world if you think small. But it's a small world if you think big. Oh, nah, that's good. That's a mind blower right there. Okay, so I think that covered all the questions. Thank you guys for the questions. I really like Kabutop shiny too. God dang, there's a bunch of shinies that I didn't know that I liked. But yeah, I think I answered all the questions. So yeah, thank you guys for the questions. Thank you for actually like reading the question of the day on the final episode and doing all that stuff. Thank you guys so much for the support. It's been awesome. But we have a long way to go still. So I guess for the rest of this episode, I'm gonna be real talking unless I like do like a little unless I speed through. I'm not gonna do a montage. I'm gonna do this all live on cam, cause these are y'all's eggs. These are y'all's eggs. I am not gonna skip over any of these eggs. See, that was all the questions. So let's just start real talking right now. So we got Fortune X Silver. That has to be the Weavile that guy sent. This is one Pokemon that I wanted to use for my friend. So we got, and then we got Flutter, we got Pork Monkey, and we got Ice Queen. Alright, there we go. Alright, so I've closed out the questions now. Ooh, man, these shinies are nice, god dang. But yeah, once again, I want to thank you guys so much for the awesome support on this series. I'll tell you guys another story. I don't know if you guys were here. There's a Sneasel from Guy. Dang it, I wish I would have used this. Alright, just in honor of Guy. If he's watching this, probably not. I'm gonna name him X Silver. I'm definitely gonna keep this, this save file for this Egglocke. Because this is probably my favorite series to record. And if you guys didn't remember, or weren't around, whenever I posted the egg sending video for you guys to send eggs and like the instructions and all that, whenever I put that up, Like, I honestly was kind of scared. Like, I didn't think that this series would be as successful as it was, because before I started the series, I had about, I don't think there was many people watching, like, to be honest with you guys. And so I was kind of scared that, like, nobody would send any eggs in to the series. That's why, of course, I wasn't really strict on the eggs. Like, I let you guys send as many eggs as you wanted to, and I would let you guys send any legendaries if you wanted to as well. Just so I would have at least some eggs, because at the most, I would think I would have got like one box full of eggs. That's like the most eggs that I thought I would have got. And I was scared about this series. Like, am I gonna have to cancel this series because no eggs are gonna be sent in? Like, that's where I was whenever I was like decided to do an Egglocke. Because I don't even have 1,000 subscribers. Like, it's crazy how much support I got from this, and I'm not even at 1,000 subscribers. But yeah, and then the first, and then I so I checked my email for the eggs, right? Okay, so let me show you the names real quick. So we got Tongue Game, that's a Lickitung probably. We got Itachi, we got GB Luke, which is probably a Rotom. We got Sea King, I don't know what that is, and we got Flick. All right, but yeah, so I checked my email for the egg for the one. What is it? What am I trying to say? I checked the email for you guys to send the eggs, right? And I saw somebody that sent in the eggs. I was like, yes! Like, you don't know, like, it was like so uplifting for me just to see that somebody like saw my video, followed the instructions that I set, and emailed me their eggs. Like, I was like, yes, we've actually got some eggs. And then over that day and the next day, there was like, I think there was like 5 or 6 people that sent in their eggs. And it wasn't even just one egg. People actually like sent in like over like 10 eggs, like 5 eggs, even like 20 eggs. People started sending them, like, as many eggs. They literally sent as many eggs as they wanted. And I was like, keep it coming. Like, I'm not like, there's no restrictions, man. Like, I'm not too big of a YouTuber, so you can send as many eggs as you want. Like, it's awesome. Like just seeing my email fill up with people sending their eggs, I was like, it made me feel really good about my channel. Like, it made me look forward to doing this series. Like, it was a good time at the beginning of the series, and it's still a good time after this series, because some of you guys let me know in the comments that this series was my first series that you saw. Like, this Egglocke was a reason how you found my channel. So it was definitely a fun time. Definitely a fun time around the 6 months that we started this series. So Trapinch, what the heck? Wait, which Pokemon are we on? I kinda wanna guess the nicknames. Oh, that was the last one, okay. So alright, so let's put this. I think Trapinch was Ice Queen. I think that was a nickname for the Trapinch. What the heck? Ice Queen, huh? But yeah, once again, thank you guys for sending all these eggs, man. I would never expected to see any of these eggs. I'm at a loss for words. Loss for words, man. Alright, and we still have two more boxes after this. God dang. Two more boxes? Yeah, this is gonna be an hour episode. For show. Faux show. Alright, so we got Iggy, which is probably an Igglybuff. Fabolution, which is probably an Eevee. We got Evil. I don't know what that is. We got Jay. Is that another Elekid? And we got Hitler. That's probably a Probopass, because of the Hitler mustache on a Probopass. That's what my guess would be. Alright, but yeah, so as I'm recording this, it is November 2nd. Y'all probably guys see this tomorrow, which is November 3rd. Oh, it's not Smoochum, Iggy the Smoochum. What the heck? Has someone seen my video where I said that I would name Smoochum Iggy Azalea? That's hilarious. Oh, I love that nickname. Thanks whoever sent Iggy. But yeah, y'all guys should see this on Thursday the 3rd of November. Hey, I got the Eve right. And so yeah, after this, this is the last video ever for this Pokemon Sacred Gold Egglocke series. Because I already posted my death montage. And So the egg hatching episode is the final thing that we'll ever see from the Sacred Gold Egglocke. So, and it'll be the third when y'all see this, so we'll have about 2 weeks. Yeah, we'll have about 2 weeks gaps between this series and the Sun and Moon series. Just because... Was that a male combi? Bro, that's cruel. Oh, man. Okay. Oh, that's funny. And then, so yeah, we have 2 weeks of... Oh, Dunsparce. I love Dunsparce. I don't know why. Okay. But yeah, we have about 2 weeks of no series on my channel, so just hope you guys will stay patient. I will do my best to record still some more Pokemon series. I am trying to plan a battle with beginners. I am trying to do another battle or record with another person for that series. So that's probably about two battles right there. I don't know what else to record because I'm waiting for Moon to come out. And yeah, I already told you guys that I pre-ordered Pokemon Moon like I think 2 weeks ago. And all right, let's get these guys over here. Yeah, I pre-ordered Moon about 2 weeks ago, right? So I'm just waiting for November 18th to drop so I can just scoop up my Pokemon Moon copy from GameStop. And then I do plan on recording, this is gonna be crazy because I do plan on recording Pokemon Moon, the first episode. I plan on recording it and having it uploaded the first day it comes out, so that Friday that Pokemon Moon comes out, I plan on having a episode uploaded for you guys for that. Okay, so we got Staryu, we got No Name, we got Metro, we got Last Hope, and we got Nagini. Metro, okay, alright. But here's the one thing that kind of been concerning me. As I told you guys, I don't have a 3DS capture card. Which is pretty obvious why I haven't recorded Pokemon X and Y or any 6th-gen games on my channel. Yeah, I don't have a... Because it's too broke. I think the last time I checked... I don't have enough money to spend on that 3DS capture card yet. But the last time I checked, I think it was like $200, which is actually the cheapest it's been. I think they're usually like $300 or $400, but now they're just $200 to get a capture card. But still, I don't have that money. So I did plan on recording on my phone, and I did buy like a cheap little phone stand that was like probably like $15 to hold my phone in place, like a little tripod for my phone. And so I just have that sitting there while I'm recording my 3DS. So it's gonna be like the most ghetto let's play that you'll ever see on my channel, and probably on Sun and Moon all around YouTube that day. It'll be the most ghetto let's play you'll see. But hey, I'm too excited for the game, and I just want to record it like no matter what. So, yeah, it'll be a ghetto let's play, for sure. And usually whenever I play a Pokemon game, whenever I get a new Pokemon game, I play it like crazy. Like, it takes me like probably like 1 or 2 days to beat the game. Whenever a new Pokemon game comes out, it takes me like 1 or 2 days. So, just a little heads up that I'm gonna be bulk recording a bunch for that series. And based on how much time I have, I think I'll probably post a video. Here we go. Alright, so we got Lucifer, we got F Tang, which is probably Matang. We got Manny, Possessed, and Leche. That's probably a Miltank. But yeah, I do plan on post, depending on how much I record on Moon on the first day I get it, I'll probably post that series every day or every other day. Like, yeah, that's probably the schedule for that series whenever I get it, start recording it. I don't think I'm gonna do a layout, like, to be honest with you guys. I think I'm probably just gonna upload the raw footage from my phone straight to YouTube. Like, I'm not gonna do any editing on that series, mainly because that Friday whenever I get the game, I'm supposed to go back to my house, which is 4 hours away, so I have to drive 4 hours right when I get out of school and then come back. But I want to get Pokemon Moon, record an episode to have it up on that Friday as well. So it's gonna be like a little crunch time right there. Like, I'll probably try recording one episode right when I get the game. Have it uploading while I'm driving to my house, which is 4 hours away. And then when I get there, what was it? I think when I get to the house, I think that the rest of that weekend and the rest of the next week is Thanksgiving break. So yeah, I think whenever I get to the house, I'll probably record like the rest of the game. Like, bulk record like at least 20 episodes in one day. So that'll be pretty fun though. It'll be pretty fun. Miltank, Leche, I guessed it right. But yeah, I'll definitely be recording when I get home the day after Sun and Moon comes out. So whenever I'm at home though, I won't have this computer to edit at all, so that's why I'm thinking I'm gonna probably have to just upload the raw footage from my phone straight to YouTube. Like, there's gonna be no intro in the video, there's gonna be no layout, which a layout was something I really wanted to do. I wanted to try implementing it onto my videos just to make it less ghetto, instead of just recording the top screen of the 3DS with my phone, which is probably suck, but I don't know. And since I don't have my... Oh, I forgot to show the nicknames. But yeah, since I don't have my... I won't have my computer throughout the whole fall break, I won't be able to make a thumbnail or post a thumbnail. So there's gonna be no thumbnails. And well, I'll probably update the thumbnails when I get back here to have to edit and all that stuff, but other than that, there'll be no thumbnail. It'll be the raw footage of Pokemon Moon. And alright, so we got Scorpion, Lord, Pingu, and Slims. I think Pingu is a Piplup, and this is a Skorupi. That's my guess. Okay. So yeah, it's gonna be ghetto. So I'm just telling you guys, just so you know what to expect. Like, don't get your hopes up for like any fancy stuff. Just saying. Okay, so I guess this one wrong. Alright, so let's keep on going. Don't expect anything fancy from me. Until I get a 3DS capture card, I hope that I will. Or I hope that something will happen. Which actually, I'm not asking you guys to like donate or anything like that right now, but I'm just letting you guys know that there's actually a... It's been on my channel for a while, but there's like a fan funding button that it says support on the button, and on top of it I have like currently saving up for a 3DS capture card. Hey, I guess this one, right? But yeah, that's been there for a while on my channel, and that button's for like people who, of course, like would really want to like, they would really want to help out this channel and like help me get a 3DS capture card to actually make let's plays on 6th and 7th gen games. Like, that would make my... That would actually expand my channel's potential a lot, to be able to record my 3DS instead of just being limited to emulators for the DS. But yeah, of course, it's only for people who really want to do that. Which... I haven't got anything... So, I'm not really... I haven't got anything for like a year since that fan funding thing has been up, so I'm honestly not expecting anything. I'm not asking you guys, I'm just letting you guys know that if you want to, there's actually an option to help me out with a 3DS capture card. Okay, so we got Sold Snake. I think that should be Solid Snake, but Sold Snake, Thor, Hunter, Scorpion again, and then Siren. Alright, let's hatch him up. So yeah, which actually reminds me, there can be a bunch of series for a potential if I were able to get a 3DS capture card. There's actually, I think I made a list Let me see. Let me check it out. I made a list somewhere of my series. So yeah, I made a list of the series that I've had in order. So my first Pokemon series was Leaf Green. Pokemon Leaf Green Let's Play. It wasn't really anything too much. There was no twist to it at all. It was just me playing a Pokemon game for the first time on YouTube. That was a funny series, actually. Like, I was just trying to find my commentary voice, find the things that I want to talk about on every video. And so, I actually did pretty good. Like, to be honest with you guys, whenever I first started YouTube, I started out with probably about like 10 subscribers already, just because I made my YouTube channel along with some other friends and we all subscribed to each other, so I had like 10 subscribers to start out with. And I got decent views. Some other people found my channel, subscribed and all that stuff. And this was way back 3 years ago, back when like I had no subscribers pretty much, or that back when I had like very little subscribers. Like, my friend had 60 subscribers and I had only like 11 probably, and we all looked at him like, oh man, he has a lot of subscribers, he has 60 subscribers. that's how little our channels were back then when I started the Leaf Green Let's Play. And then yeah, so I definitely wasn't, I don't feel like I'm too big of a YouTuber still, like, well, definitely not, but like, I haven't had this much support all the time, like, to be honest. Like, everybody starts from somewhere, right? Everybody has to start with nothing. Unless people just, like, automatically gain, like, thousands of subscribers in one day, which is, like, I don't know how that's possible. Alright, so we got Rockley, Jared, Soren, Pangea? What's the name of that? I know that's, like, the Earth. That's, like, a theory about the Earth. Pangea. I don't know how to pronounce it. And we got Tracer. Alright, so yeah, my Leaf Green playthrough, just basic stuff. And then my second Let's Play was my Pokemon Soul Silver Mono Bug run through, which definitely was I still refer to it as my most successful series on my channel, because I think every video got at least 100 views and like a decent amount of likes. Like, I probably like 6 or at least 5 likes on each video, which is pretty crazy. Yeah, that's when my channel like started growing like pretty rapidly. Like, I think I gained like, I went to like 200 and something subscribers from that series, and then everybody saw me as like the viral dude on YouTube, like around my friends and all that stuff. And then I kept on going. I think I made it to like 700 subscribers. I ended that Soul Silver Let's Play and did a Pokemon Emerald Randomized Nuzlocke Challenge, and between those two series, my channel got to like 700 subscribers. Yeah, 700 subscribers, I would think. And then, yeah, that was crazy. You know, like, I should have kept on going with that stuff, but I don't know why. Somewhere after that Emerald Randomized Nuzlocke Challenge, I lost motivation for Pokemon, and like, that's when I got into Minecraft a lot. And I think that's when my channel's like, the growth stopped, because like, people got confused about my channel being Pokemon or Minecraft. But yeah, so that's when my channel like stopped growing a lot. And then I think overall, for like my next like 5 series after that, I did a Platinum Time Warp Challenge. Oh, what the heck am I doing? But yeah, after that, my channel like slowed down a little bit after the Randomized Nuzlocke Challenge. So then the next series after that, and for like the next 5 series, my channel was like just like static. I did a Platinum Time Warp Challenge, which is a crazy weird challenge. You'd have to like see the rules for that to understand it. And then I did a Pokemon Yellow Monotype, or Pokemon Yellow Normal Monotype Challenge. It was actually a pretty funny series, actually. And then I did a Pokemon Crystal Hunger Games Challenge, which is another crazy challenge, which you'd have to read the rules to see it, but I don't think anybody else has done it before. So we got QB, Ducks, No Name, Mustang, and Cyclone. Alright. And then I did a Pokemon Black Randomizer Nuzlocke Challenge. I did a Pokemon Glaze Nuzlocke Challenge, which was my first Pokemon hack. Which is my... That's when I started like getting into layouts on my videos. And then I did a Pokemon Diamond Sacred, or I did a Pokemon Diamond Randomizer Nuzlocke Challenge, which is my last series. And then I got here to the Sacred Gold Challenge, or to the Sacred Gold Egglocke Challenge. And then from this series, that's when my channel started growing up again. Because I think for like the past, for the last 6 series, my channel peaked at like 860 subscribers, somewhere around there. And then over the last 2 years, when I did the all those series, my like people started up subscribing, and like I got down to like 800 subscribers. Like I think that was like a few months ago. My channel was just like static at 800 subscribers. And then I joined Aftershock, which was a Minecraft server, a few months ago. That people from Aftershock, that got me like about to 820 subscribers, something like that. Which, so it showed some growth to my channel. After like a few years, I was like pretty excited about that. And then I posted a, I don't know if you guys seen this, but I posted a reaction video, my first reaction video, which is now my most viewed video on my channel. Just a reaction video, something that I'm not even like, something my game's not even, or my channel's not even known for. It's a reaction video for the Pokemon Cypher 2016. That got about 10,000 views. Freaking Matt Houston commented on it. If you don't know him, he's one of the people that was on the Cypher. He comments on the video, and like, he's a really cool person. Like, and then I'm pretty sure because of him, like, my video got a bunch of like support on it for that reaction video. And then from that video, I like my channel gained like at least, I want to say like 30 subscribers just from that video. Which, seeing that constant growth, like, it was foreign to me. Like, after 3 years of not growing my channel at all, like, just from that video, boom, like, people started subscribing again. I was like, dang. And then, yeah, people found this Sacred Gold challenge, or this Egglocke challenge as well. People subscribed from this. It was crazy, like, my channel actually, like, is looking good now. So we got Linton, Queen, Serebii, Winry, and Pokedex. Alright. What was I saying? But yeah, my channel is looking, like, there's been times where, like, I didn't really like looking at my channel too much, because I know, like, there wasn't really anything to look at. Nobody viewed it too much, but now it's like, it feels like I enjoy being back on my channel again, like seeing my YouTube channel again, just because, like, to see if like people will like a video or see another person subscribed. It's fun. It's a fun time. Yeah, so your this Egglocke challenge has been like changed my channel, and I don't think I've told anybody this, but I decided for my channel that I'm not gonna do any Minecraft. I'm not gonna do anything Minecraft related anymore. Like, I feel like the Minecraft community on YouTube is a bit dead, and I didn't really feel like as welcomed in that community as I did for Pokemon. Or I didn't feel as comfortable doing Minecraft as I did Pokemon, of course. So I decided for this channel that I'm gonna be doing just pure Pokemon related stuff on this channel from now on. So, I mean, yeah, I don't know, unless I keep wanting doing Omegle videos, like, bring those back. I don't think I would want to, though, because I want to keep, yeah, I think I would, for this channel, I would just want to keep on doing just pure Pokemon related stuff, which actually brings me to another thing. I actually wanted to get back into battling for 7th Gen, like, start posting Pokemon battles from Sun and Moon. I think I want to get back into competitive battling again, because I think that would be really nice. But I'm not really a good competitive battler, to be honest. Like, let's just, like, if I went up against a bigger YouTuber, I'll probably get owned. Just because I don't really take the time to EV train or anything like that. Alright, so we got Fox, which is a Ho-Oh. We got No Name, we got Sleepy, we got Queen Bee, and Deliora. Probably a Delibird, maybe? I don't know. But yeah, I'll get owned, but I think I would want to try posting battles on YouTube again from Pokemon. I would be down to use it, or I'll be down to do it. Which is probably another reason why I would really... Which is like another reason why a 3DS capture card would boost the potential for my channel. Because I'd be able to post like better quality battles instead of just recording on my phone like I used to for my first video on YouTube. But I don't know. I definitely want to get into back and out competitive battling for 7th gen. Alright, so yeah, I'm just talking to you guys. I'm probably like going off subjects and you guys aren't following me. But hey, Jirachi. But yeah, so where was I going with that? Yeah, it's crazy to see my channel grow. Let's see, so after this series, you guys, well, I already told you guys that my next series is gonna be Pokemon Moon. That'll probably honestly last about 1 month. It'll probably be my shortest series. It'll probably only last about 1 month because, again, I tell you guys that I'm gonna be bulk recording it a bunch. I'll probably finish the game in like 2 or 3 days. And so, yeah, I'll probably post like every day or every other day for Pokemon Moon. And that'll probably go on for like about, I'll probably say about a month. It'll probably be my shortest series, Pokemon Moon. So then, that'll probably lead straight up to winter break for you guys. So during winter break, I'll probably start another series, which I do have. I did write down like ideas for like 3 more series after Pokemon Moon. So I think I told you guys this in one of the episodes. One of them was definitely another Egglocke, because you guys definitely let me know that this was like your favorite series, or was it how you found my series, and it was y'all really enjoyed these Egglocks. So I definitely do plan on doing another Egglock soon. I did decide that I was going to be for a 5th gen game, just because I keep on forgetting the nicknames. But yeah, it's going to be for a 5th gen game. I'm not going to tell you guys which game though, or which version or anything like that. It's going to be for a 5th gen game because it is easy to set up on an emulator. And I haven't figured out how to set up an Egglocke on a 3DS, so it'll be on a 5th gen game. So we got Trouble, Mew3, Quit, and hashtag Team Moon. Okay. So yeah, so that's another Egglocke coming soon, so I already planned another Egglocke, so don't worry if you missed this Egglocke already. I do plan on doing another Monotype run. Because you guys actually, I forgot who said it, but somebody said that they loved the mono bug, or the monotype bug run, and they wanted me to do another one of those. So I feel like the monotype challenge is like something that my channel can be known for. I don't know why, but yeah, I do plan on doing a monotype run. And then, depending on how things go, I actually wanted to do a Wonderlock on a 6th gen game. I wanted to do a Wonderlock sometime because that actually looked pretty fun, but again, the 3DS situation, I could record the Wonderlock on my phone, but I don't think I would want to do that. But I just know that a Wonderlock could be an option someday. So yeah, another Egglocke for sure, and then a Monotype run for sure. That's the plan for like probably till next summer. I just really realized that. My god dang, those next series that I just named to you guys will probably hold us over till next summer. Wow. Who knows when my channel will be in next summer? Like, if I get like 1,000 subscribers, if I hit 1,000 subscribers by next summer, I would honestly be really shocked. I'd be really shocked. I wouldn't be used to that. Okay, let's see. The nicknames. We got Shuaj, We got Steel, we got Treble Clef, we got Your Mama, and we got Lava Beast. Alright. Touch him up. But yeah, like, seeing people, like, I honestly look at my channel and I can't see my subscriber count having four digits on it. I don't know why, it just seems like, it seems unreal to me. So if it, like, I honestly don't think I don't know if I will hit it, to be honest. I'll just keep trying, keep doing my thing. But other than that, I don't know. Who knows where I'll be next summer? Or who knows how my channel will be doing next summer? Maybe I'll be at 1,000. Maybe I'll still have less than 900 right now. Which actually, so yeah, I forgot, I told you guys that my channel peaked at 860 subscribers, and that's when I started falling down to 800. I was in that little range for like the past 2 years on YouTube. And then once I joined Aftershock, and then once I started this Egglocke challenge, and once I posted that reaction video, boom, my channel like surpassed 860 subscribers, and I've had the most subscribers that I've ever had on my channel. Just from like the past month, which is crazy. I think the last time I checked, I had 888 subscribers. 888, which 8 is my favorite number. Nobody asked it, but I'll just let you guys know 8 is my favorite number. So when all three of my subscriber digits was 888, I was like, oh, we got the good luck charm now. But yeah, that's the most subscribers I ever had on my channel. So channel is in a good, it's in a good spot right now. So I can't even complain. I'm not even mad. So yeah, that's why I'm saying, like, who knows where the heck I'll, who knows what my channel will be looking like and throughout next summer. I expect it to be pretty small still. Like, I'll tell you guys what, I honestly won't expect my channel to be like a big channel. Like, I honestly don't think I'll make it on YouTube unless I add like 2 zeros after all the numbers on my channel. Like, you add 2 zeros after my subscriber count, it's like how much is that? That's 88,000, something like that. And you add 2 zeros after my view count, which would probably be like 3,000 to 4,000. And then like 2 zeros after my like counts, it's like 200, something like that. 100 likes every video. That's when I'll think I would have made it on YouTube. All right, so we got Death, we got Sacred, Blue Sacred, Baby Power, and Mew 5. What's up with all these Mews? All right. But yeah, I honestly don't think that. I honestly can't see myself making it on YouTube, like having 2 zeros after all my numbers right now. Like, honestly, that's crazy. If that ever happened, like, I'd probably like quit everything and just like be a YouTuber. That'd be pretty funny though. But no, I honestly don't expect that. But I'm just doing this as a hobby though, which is why I'm in college, so don't have to rely on it. So I actually have like a decent job waiting for me after college, hopefully, instead of just like rely on YouTube. My boy Suicune. But yeah, that's my take on my channel. I don't know where the heck, I don't know, I think I'll be around the same size by next summer, and I don't think I'll ever have like, I don't think I'll ever make it on YouTube with having 2 zeros after all my numbers. So yeah, but you heard it from me now, see, because you never know what can happen. And I am surprised I have been talking this much. I've been talking for pretty much an hour straight, guys. I'm surprised my voice isn't gone. It feels like it kind of is going away a little bit. So I've been talking for over an hour, like, what the heck? If you guys have been watching up to this point in this video, let me comment down below if you watched this far in this video. Because some of you guys actually watched up to an hour on that one video where, I forgot what video it was, but it was over an hour long, and you guys watched for up to an hour on that video too. So let me guys know if you watched up to an hour on this video as well, which I hope you guys will how you guys did, because you'll see me hatching all your eggs, man. Alright, so this, we have this batch, and we have one more batch after this to hatch. So, we're almost done though, we're almost done. So, here we go, we got Thorn, we got Cookie, we got Shady, which is probably Delibird. We got Arachne, and then we got Migi. I think Thorn is like a, I was about to say Pharaoh Thorn, but that's, I forgot, this is a fifth, sixth, this is a fourth gen game. So who can be Thorn? Oh, I get it, Roselia with the thorns on its head. Alright, so yeah, we've been hatching eggs, we had a bunch of real talk on my channel. Yeah, we had a bunch of real talk on my thoughts about my channel and the videos so far, and about the future of the channel. Some real talk, this is why I kind of like this, just like, let you guys know everything that's going on with my in my head, and let you guys know what to expect from my channel, because we never really have this much real talk in a series before, or in a video in general. And then we also answered questions that you guys wanted to know about me. Hey, Delibird, Shady the Delibird. But yeah. Which, oh yeah, so one other thing that I would think would be pretty cool though is to collab with like the crazy YouTubers that I watch. Like, I think that would be another sign that I would think I would have made it on YouTube. Like, if I was able to collab with like some of the bigger YouTubers that I watch on YouTube, like King Nappy or Shady, like we just hatched right there. Like, those are the guys that, those guys would be like, it'll be, I wouldn't, if I was in a call with them, recording with them, I wouldn't believe, I would think I was dreaming or something. That'd be pretty funny. Alright, so let's go over there. Alright, so we have a little bit more eggs to hatch. We're almost done. And my voice is almost giving out. Whew, we got this, guys, we got this, we got this. This is why streaming is actually really hard, because people stream for like an hour, at least an hour, and they usually talk for like, oh, we have two batches left, shoot. Yeah, people talk a lot throughout their streams, and they stream for like about over an hour. I don't know how they do that without losing, like, streaming takes a bunch of energy. I speak from experience when I used to do that, like, last summer, back when I had decent internet. So we got Darp, Derp, Nappy, Lunoir, and Jafar. I think that's an Abra right there. And Nappy is, of course, going to be a Gengar or a Ghastly. Let's go. I feel like I should have been super speeding through all this eggs. Nah, never mind. A Bidoof is Darp. Not bad, not bad. Alright. Here we go. But yeah, so you heard it from me now. Minecraft content is no more on my channel. Unless I don't know, I might record like a BEL and PvP adventure. I think those are the only Minecraft things that I would actually want to record. Yeah, I think one PvP adventure, maybe. Which would, oh, there's Nappy. But yeah. But that would only happen like over the summer when I have decent internet. But as of now, it's just pure Pokemon for me. Which, for the next 2 weeks, we don't have much content to post, so I'm going to try posting some battles if I can with some other people. Maybe. I'll try it. But 2 weeks of no series to post, like, I'm going to have to post nothing but battles. Like, if I want to keep my content, if I want to keep my content pure Pokemon. I don't know. That's gonna be hard. But I won't. I'll find something. Trust me. I'll try finding something. All right. So this should be the pretty much the last full batch of eggs to hatch now. Dunsparce and Bidoof. What if I had those two hatched as my starters, Derp and Darp? That would have been a. That would have made this Egglocke more interesting for sure. Alright, so we got two more eggs after this batch. Alright. And then I could finally rest my voice, because I feel like I'm sick trying to talk right now. My voice is just gone. Now we got Dolph, we got Cal, we got Goro, we got Yo Mama again. What's up with Yo Mamas? We got Iron Avian. Man, my mom was in this Egglocke a lot. We had a bunch of mamas in here. Shout out to my baby mamas. Nah, just kidding. Okay. Zigzagoon, man. I want to look over all the Pokemon that we hatched. Like, what were the odds? What were the potential? Like, what were the options that we had? I want to look at all the options that we had in this series. Like, honestly. Like, what if there was an Egglocke where there was one of every Pokemon? Like, there was one of every Pokemon that was in an Egglocke. Or that, yeah, that was able to be hatched. That would be pretty insane. Like, every Pokemon would be different. You wouldn't have any duplicates either. That would be insane. We got Machop. Machop. Alright, let's keep on going. So we have... We're coming down to the last three eggs in this... In this whole entire series to ever be hatched. Munchlax! Hey, Munchlax, you should... Which actually reminds me, apparently if you pre-order Sun and Moon, you get a Munchlax that comes with a Z-move. So hopefully I'll be getting a Munchlax with a Z-move when I get the game. That'd be pretty cool. I'll have a Popplio, or not Popplio, what the heck? I'll have a Rowlet as my starter, and then I'll have a Munchlax along with it. Ooh, I can't wait to see. I can't wait to see how my team looks in Moon. I can't wait to see what I... Because I have a general idea of what Pokemon I want to use, but I don't know exactly what my team is going to be yet. So, I'm pretty dang excited, not gonna lie. Alright, here we go, guys. The last two Pokemon to ever be hatched in this series. You got Bird Jesus and Liam, which I think these are the most recent eggs that were sent in, so whoever was the last one to send eggs, these are the last Pokemon. Bird Jesus and Liam. Sharp Beak and Soothbell. What if this is like Ho-Oh and Lugia? That'd be like perfect. That'd be like perfect for this series. Alright, Bird Jesus. The second to last Pokemon. It's a Pidgey. Hey, Pidgeot is pretty power though. Kazooie all the way. Leaf Green put in the work for Kazooie. Alright guys, Liam is our final Pokemon. Is our final egg to ever be hatched in this Egglocke challenge. In this series. Not challenge, this whole series. Liam. Holding the soup bell. Alright. It's our last egg, guys. And our last egg is a soup bell. Freaking soup bell, I assume. That's actually really ironic. Because I'm going to be honest with you guys. Zubat is my least favorite Pokemon. Like, if you guys watch Nappy, you would know that Wingull or Pelipper is his least favorite Pokemon. Like, he hates that with a passion. Zubat is equivalent to Pelipper for me. Like, I don't know why I hate Zubat the most. They're so annoying. And they're so annoying in the wild, and they're not even powerful until they evolve. My most hated Pokemon is the last egg hatch in this series. It's special. I mean, it's a special egg hatch, but that's freaking hilarious. That's hilarious. Oh my gosh, a Zubat. That's perfect. That's actually perfect. End with a bitter taste in my mouth for this series. No, just kidding. Alright. So, this is all the... So, look at all the options we had, man. There was so much diversity. That would have been cool to have a Miltank. It had a Curse, too. A Curse Miltank. Wrath of Miltank. We had a bunch of legendaries too, like god dang. Like whenever I said you were able to send in legendaries, people took my word for that. Like not gonna lie. People took my word for sending as many eggs as you want too, so. That's depending on how big my channel is for the next Egglocke, there'll probably be similar requirements. Like you can send in legendaries and as many eggs as you want. There'll probably be similar requirements for the next Egglocke as well. Considering my channel doesn't like blow up, which is unlikely. Okay, so now this is our dead box as you saw in our death montage. I hope you like that death montage, by the way. All of these were crazy. These were all the options we had, and these were the legit options we had too. Oh man, it hasn't hit me, guys. It hasn't hit me that we caught this many Pokemon. First of all, that's a lot. It hasn't hit me that this Egglocke is done. Like, I'm not gonna have any, like, series to record after this. for the next few weeks, at least. Wow. Okay. And this is the last time we'll see. Let's go through the box again. This is the last time we're gonna see the boxes. So these are all the Pokemon that we caught, right? Okay, these are all the Pokemon that we caught. Which was actually the best. We actually were really good at consistent at catching Pokemon. These are the Pokemon that were I deemed not legal to use. And these are the Pokemon that were able to be that were legal to use throughout the series. Freaking unknown, man. That would have been awesome to use. And these are the Pokemon. This is the dead Pokemon. These are the Pokemon that we weren't able to hatch through the series, but they were there, so thank you guys. Oh yeah, so yeah. Oh man. Thank you guys once again, man. I don't say it enough, but thank you guys for watching this whole series and showing the craziest support that I've ever seen on this on my channel. Thank you guys so much for sending in the eggs and showing the support on this series. If you watch this whole entire video, let me know in the comments, man. And just to show you guys one last time of how we end it, this is our final team. This is how, these are the champs of the game. We pulled through with Jack, the King is gone. Adamant Nature. Frodo the Frostlass, Naive Nature. Swim Kirby the Politoed. Adamant again. Mew4 the Mesprit, also Adamant. These were our warriors who came through towards at the end of the series. That was our team. That's our team. That was what's left of our team after the series. Alright, so an hour and 20 minutes. God dang, this is a long video. Alright, so I'm going to go ahead and end off right here. But I'll tell you guys something. I'm not good at ending off series. I'm not good at ending off series. But I'm going to do my best. Alright, so yeah, so thank you guys once again. I can't thank you guys enough for the success of this series right here. The success of this series was purely based on how you guys supported it. So I want to thank you guys so much once again for allowing this series to be possible. Thank you guys for watching this series, commenting and liking, allowing me to like react or what's not let's not react dive what's the word interact allowing me to interact with you guys in the comment section, all that stuff. Thank you guys for showing the awesome support and all that good stuff. I really thank you guys so much once again for watching this series. Any even if you watch any episode or all the episodes, thank you guys so much. So yeah, I'm going to end out the episode here. So thank you guys for watching. If you enjoyed this egg hatching video, be sure to pick up that like button down below and all that good stuff. And I will see you another day where we will be battling somebody, hopefully, or I'll see you over my next series in Pokemon Moon for my most ghetto let's play. So hope you'll stay tuned for my Pokemon Moon let's play. So yeah, thank you for watching once again. I'll see you over another day, but until then, stay safe, guys.